It was terrifying during the Cultural Revolution because all the sacred objects were destroyed. That wasn't unique to our nunnery. It happened across the country. Nothing was left, not even a stick of incense.
It's because faith is so central to the lives of Tibetans and so closely entwined with their national identity that it worries the Chinese state, of which Tibet is a part. The atheist Communist Party exercises religious tolerance as a function of political control.
Some people with insidious aims use religion to carry out activities to overthrow, to split China. Such things do happen, so we must heighten our vigilance. We have a strict line on this. The party has a policy of respecting religious freedom. If you go in for religion, your beliefs should be respected and protected. But if you use religion as a cover to try to split China or harm national security, then you're breaking the law. It's not allowed.
Violent clashes in 1988 between the police and Tibetan monks. Buddhism has been feared as a rallying point and cover for Tibetan independence. Clampdowns have alternated with concessions, tolerance with repression. Today, Tibetan Buddhism is permitted on the party's strict terms. Neither government employees nor students are allowed to practice. The state micromanages religion.
We get many applications at our nunnery for acceptance as a nun. But we can't just enroll people as and when we like. There's a limit set by the party, and that dictates our decision making.
The Communist Party isn't just worried about numbers. It also requires all applicants to be vetted. There's a spiritual vacuum in Tibet. The Dalai Lama has been away nearly half a century. Just displaying his photo can lead to arrest. It's hard to know what the pilgrims feel about their long-absent spiritual leader. Hard to know how they'd respond to his possible return, because, tellingly, it's not safe for them to discuss it. Deputy Governor Nima Tsering believes Tibetans increasingly share the party view.
More and more of the people realize what kind of person the Dalai really is. He is false and deceitful. You could say that in recent years, profound changes have occurred in Tibet. More and more of the masses realize what kind of person the Dalai is. Draped in the cloak of religion, he tries to promote Tibetan independence. So ordinary people see ever more clearly that he is trying to split the motherland and make Tibet independent.
Under the patriotic education policy, monks and nuns must sign a statement renouncing the Dalai Lama and acknowledging Tibet as an integral part of China. Some have refused and have been arrested or expelled from the monastery. Religion in China is administered by the state from the Beijing Palace where the last emperor was born. All religions are alien to communism, but Christianity has particular echoes for the party.
The The Chinese say Buddhism came in peace to China, on elephants and white horses. But the Christian God came to China riding on a cannonball. Ordinary Chinese people call Christianity the foreign religion, and naturally associate it with a history of bullying and looting China. Christianity has been adapted for China, removed of what Ye Xiaowen has called its Western taint. Shishaku is the largest Catholic church in Beijing. This is Catholicism, but it isn't Orthodox Roman Catholicism. Overseeing the Patriotic Catholic Association of China is not the Pope, 5,000 miles away in the Vatican, but the Chinese Communist Party.
It's the principle of every citizen to uphold the party's leadership. As citizens, we cannot call this into question. They are the ruling party. Our relationship with the party is that they lead, we follow. We enjoy respect in terms of our faith, and the Constitution specifically protects our beliefs. For all this, the Catholic Church thanks the Chinese Communist Party.
The state limits the number of churches, Catholic and Protestant, approves the appointment and dismissal of clergy, monitors the printing and distribution of Bibles. Perhaps 20 million worship in the officially approved churches, but some Chinese don't want anything between them and their God, least of all the avowedly atheist Communist Party. In the hour before it opens, a public swimming bath becomes a place of baptism. This is a rare glimpse into the hidden